Okay, guys, second last session. Can I ask Kobus to please join me on stage? Mr. Ehlers, how are you?
I'm well, and yourself?
Great. I'm super well. Thanks so much. Kobus, it's a privilege to have you here today. We know founders like yourself, you know, you guys are busy. For everyone who doesn't know Kobus, if there is anyone on this call, he's the founder of SnapScan, which most of us use to pay for a whole bunch of different things, including our much-loved coffee. Kobus, thank you very much for the hard work and effort on that. Absolutely adore the product. And he currently also runs a company called Radar, because they've sold SnapScan to Standard Bank. Kobus, we're asking you the big question today around execution. Like, how do you get a company to run like clockwork? And I would imagine a payments company that runs with and sells to a big bank must really kind of like work like this. And I know also in your current business, you're also focusing on kind of like, you know, standardizing complex processes and making them kind of like run like clockwork. So over to you, sir. Keen to hear what you have for us.
Sure. So I definitely don't know if I have the magic solution for how to make your company run like clockwork. It's a difficult question, but I do have some ideas and maybe five things I can share from our experience. I think there's also, as you also phrased it, I think there's an important difference depending on the life cycle of your business. It's definitely a different configuration when you start out to when you start scaling up and really growing that business. But I think there are some common themes that run through it for us. I think one of the most important ones, and maybe my first observation, will be that it's really important to set clear goals for what you're doing at any given time. That means maybe having a bit of a longer term roadmap and having context so that people in your business know why they're doing what they're doing. But then also those very annoying granular goals that give you an idea of what you should be doing this sprint, this month, this quarter, and this year. And of course, you can absolutely change them as you go along. But I think having some kind of idea of why we're doing it and where we're on our way to really helps in keeping people focused and getting things in order. I think for us also, what has been really maybe my most important tip would be the second one, which is just make sure that you have the best possible team that you can when you're building your business. I don't think there's anything more important than having really, really good people. And I think that applies to basically any business and any industry that you're in. So for me, when starting a business or when growing a business, it's really about working with people who you can trust and getting the best possible talent and skills available to you in that business. And that's not an easy thing to do. There, once again, isn't a magic solution to it. There isn't one service that you can go to that can help you with recruitment and solves all of your problems. It is a constant investment. It's about building networks. It's about also really getting to know yourself as a business and understanding what is a good fit for you. So when we hire and recruit, quite often it is not about finding the best candidate out there. It's about finding the best candidate for us. And to be able to do that, you need to be quite focused in terms of what your requirements are and what you need. Maybe the third thing to think about there is, how do you empower people in your business? When you say you want things to run like clockwork, for us, a lot of that is about reducing meetings and coordination and sign-offs and different levels in the business. So it's about saying, can we make that decision happen as close to the people executing on it as possible? And that means delegating authority. It means ensuring that your structure is in such a way that you don't have large bureaucracies in circumstances where it doesn't make sense. It's not the case in all situations. So if I take our current business, we still do a payments bit, disbursing salaries for employees. In those kind of contexts, of course, there is separation of duties, there's audit trails, there's quite formal processes, there's oversight, because that is fit for that purpose. When it is a decision in terms of changing the branding on a support page, that process is a lot more lightweight because it doesn't make any sense to put those heavy structures on top of it. So I think seeing if it's possible to empower your employees as much as possible really helps when you start growing. In my experience, generally, if you're four or five people in a business, it's almost never an issue because anything you want can get resolved by just getting everybody in a room and sorting it out. But as you start growing at sort of 15 or 20 or 50 people, you have to make sure that people understand what their roles are, which decisions can they make, and where does that responsibility ultimately lie. And hopefully most of the responsibilities in that business lie first and foremost with the teams. And sure, there's an oversight role for the management or the executive team, but make those decisions as close to the point where they need it as possible. I think the fourth thing for us that is important is automate. You've mentioned it a few times today, but I think really getting automation in place as early as possible is crucial. We're in such a privileged position today that technology can help us solve so many of these repetitive tasks that you have to handle as a business. And reducing that cognitive load and making sure that these things happen smoothly is really something that we can use software systems for. In fact, that's one of the key reasons why we started Radar. So what we do there is look at all of your HR and your payroll needs in one sort of integrated fashion. We don't do the kind of accounting side of things, but we say, if you want to manage all of your employees, there are a whole bunch of processes and procedures and policies that we can automate. And by putting that in an easy to use online platform, it allows you to get those processes in place when you have 3 or 4 employees, and that grows with your business instead of trying to catch up when you're going through a due diligence process or you need to figure out how you're going to sustain your growth. So automate as much as you possibly can and leverage those amazing tools that are out there, a lot of which are really affordable and lightweight to get started with. And then maybe the last thing I'll mention, we only have so much time, but the last thing I'll mention is find a way to make your wins tangible. When we're working on building a business, it's sometimes so easy to get lost in the weeds and not take that time to celebrate what you are actually achieving and those wins that you have. So I think it is, if it's a product, it's about really understanding why you're doing development or building on a specific product and marking those moments when you release that to customers. If it's on service, it's perhaps having really close contact with those customers and understanding the feedback that they give you in terms of the service you provide. But I think pausing and reflecting on what you have achieved is as important as setting those long-term goals and working towards that and ultimately towards a sustainable business.
Kobus, and that's a powerful session. Thank you so much for bringing it across so concisely. I love that automation process is just focus on getting those things right, get your communication right, and yeah, it's a stellar to hear you just kind of like articulated in this way. Thank you for sharing that with us. It's really a privilege to have you today, and so good to see you, man.
Thanks so much.
Cool. Good luck with Radar, guys. Have a look at it.
Thanks.
Hey, Lo here, one of the founders of Outsource CFO. If you enjoyed this video, make it official. Click subscribe.